It's Daps. Welcome to my YouTube channel. I am excited to share another video with you. And in this video, I want to show you how you can clone a WordPress website with and without a plugin. So I'll be showing you two super simple, easy ways for you to clone your WordPress website. First, with a plugin, and secondly, without a plugin. So it means that we'll go to our hosting account, we're going to download our website files and our database so that you have options when you are trying to clone or duplicate or copy, whatever English you want to use, your WordPress website. So without further ado, let's get started immediately. So right on my screen here is a test website. It's called mycbmastery.com. So I want to clone this website to another website I have here called daps.dapsbook.com. So it's a subdomain. Let's get started. So we're going to come to the first website here. We're going to come to the backend. We would first start with a plugin, and we'll come to plugins. We'll come to add new. We'll search for a plugin called WP Vivid. So we have this plugin here. That's 300,000 active installations. So we're going to install this plugin on both websites. So let's come to the back end of this website too as well, and let's come to plugins. Let's come to add new. We're going to search for WP Vivid as usual. So we're going to install this plugin here too as well. So let's come back here and let's activate this, and then let's come back here to and activate this. We have this plugin WP Vivid installed on both sides. So on the receiving WordPress website here, what we have to do is to come to keys, and then we have to generate a key, and then we can copy this key, right click and copy this, and then we can come back to the website we want to clone, and then we can come to auto migration. We can paste our key here, and then we can save this. That's it. Your connection is okay. Now you can transfer this website to this, exactly what we want to do. So we're going to scroll down here. We'll see a place that says clone, then transfer. So we're going to click this, and this would literally clone this website here. As you're seeing here, it's cloning. And once it's done cloning, it will send it to our receiving website. So that's literally everything we need to do to use a plugin. Super easy, and you can get this done in some few minutes. So let's give this time to finish cloning and then transfer our website. All right, so it says here one backup task finish. Now have this backup done. So let's come back here, and then let's come to backup and restore. Let's scroll down. Let's hit this scan backup and received backup. So you can see that we have received the backup, and what we can do is for us to just hit the restore button, and then hit this restore button as well, and click OK button here, and then this website will restore our backup. This may take some few seconds, so we're going to give this some time to finish up. And please do not switch this page when this restoration is going, because it could trigger some unexpected errors. So we can see restore completed successfully. If we click this OK button, it will log us out, and then we can see that our restore should be done. So as you can see, if we come back here now, let's do a refresh. Super simple. We have our clone done within split seconds. This is super, super easy to do with this plugin called WP Vivid. So if we come back here, for us to be able to log in back to the backend, we have to use the credential of our initial website now on the new website. That's exactly how it works. Fantastic. So I'm in the backend of this website right now, and you can see what I love more about this clone is that if you come to the front end, all our URL has been updated. So if I click this buy now right now, it will load Daps Brook or daps.dapsbook.com. It won't redirect me. I don't need to change URL, update URL. Every URL from the old website has been converted to the new website. Super simple. That's everything we need to do. Now let's go to the second method. But before I do that, I want to restore this website back to default. So I can just come to plugins. I can come to add new. search for a plugin called WP Reset. So we have this plugin here. It is installed already. Good. So I can activate this. So plugin activated. So we have this pop-up here. And then we can just come to tools/WP Reset. And then we can scroll down, down, down. And we can come down here and we can just type in reset. This WordPress website has been formatted to default. So if we come back here right now and we do a refresh, so you can see we have WordPress 2024 theme installed. That's it. That's exactly how to restore your website back. So let's see how we can clone this website without a plugin. So let's come to our hosting. For the purpose of this example, I will be using Hostinger. Hostinger is the current hosting for both domains, so it will make things very, very easy for us. I can come to my website. Here is my cbmastery.com, the website I want to clone. I can just easily manage this. All right, so two things we need to do. We need to back up our website files and also our database. So you can see that we have quick access to them here, our website file and our database. So let's start first with our file manager. And let's come back as well. Let's launch our database too as well. Okay, so we have our database here. So if we scroll down, this is my database. So I can enter my PHP, my admin. And then we can come to our files here. I can come to my public underscore HTML. This is the same no matter the cPanel you're using. Unfortunately, Hostinger is using hPanel. If you're using cPanel, just go to your file manager. You can type your file manager into search in your cPanel. You should be able to access your file manager like this. So to back this up, I can just click this. I can just do Control A for all of them. I can right click. And then I can archive this. I can archive this to zip or to tar or to whatever I want, but zip is always okay. So that's it for this. This is being archived. So let's come back to our database. We have our database opened here. If we scroll down, this is what our database files look like. So what we want to do here is for us to check all the tables. So checking here, we highlight all the tables. We can click this button here for us to export these tables, or we can just easily hit the export button here. I'm getting some unusual errors. I don't know why the export button is not working, but I think maybe phpMyAdmin is not working very well with this browser, because that's the only thing that can come to my head right now. I would experiment with this eventually in another browser to see what could be the error. But let's come back here and see, and we can see that we now have this zip file here. So what we can do here ideally is to just download this, or right click this and then you can download this to your computer. So for our files here, I will have to come back to Hostinger account and I need to search for the domain that I want to transfer this to. I'll come back to websites. I'll come to Dapsbrook here and I will manage this. And then I can come to my file manager here. Okay, so now we can come to our public underscore HTML. And we already have a WordPress website file here. So what we're going to do here is to delete all the files here because we want to replace it with the other one. So we're going to Control A everything here and we're going to right click and we're going to delete everything. Deleted. This is now empty. So that's fantastic. So if we come down here, now we have a zip file here. So now let's right click this and let's just entirely download this. So we have these files downloading and that's good. So while this is downloading, let's come back here and let's see if we can. This is still not responding. So I have this opened up in Chrome now. So let's check this if this would respond here. So let's check this. Okay, and then let's hit the export button. So you can see, so I think phpMyAdmin is not working well with Opera Mini, so you have to take notes. So we want this downloaded as SQL, which is okay. So I'll hit go. So as you can see, our database is downloading and that's it. So we have our website files and our database downloading already. So coming back here, zip2 has been downloaded and that's fine. So let's come back here and then let's come to our download here. Let's just drag our zip file here. So now this is uploaded now to our new website. We can come back as well and let's come to our database for our new website, which is Daps Brook. We have an existing a lot of database here, as a matter of fact. But what I would do is that I would just try to create a new database. Let's just call this cloned. I have to create a username for my database. I can call this Daps and I'll give it a password. Database created successfully. This is the database here. I can then enter PHP my admin. Let's see if it will work in this browser this time around. Let's try to import right now to upload our clone database. We just have to choose our file here, and then I have my database here, so I'm going to click this and then I'm going to scroll down here and hit the import button. So this would install our new database. This may take some few minutes depending on how heavy your database files are. You have to give this some time to finish up. Okay, so we have our database uploaded, but unfortunately we have these errors here, two errors basically, but I think we will try to see if you can manage this. All right, so if I click this right now, I think I should have my tables here. Let's hope that the errors would not affect our import. So that's it for this. So let's come back to our file manager here. So we have our WP content here uploaded. So now let's click this and let's right click this. Let's try to extract this. Let's just give this a demo folder destination called Daps. And then let's extract this. Alright, so we have this in Daps, so we'll open this up. So this is our files here. We're going to right click all of this and we're going to move this. We want to move it back to public_HTML and not inside Daps. So I'll click this. I can see that this is in my public_HTML. So what we'll do with Daps is to just right click and delete this. We don't need this again. And then we can just keep this as a backup. So what we want to do right now is that we want to integrate our WP config with our new database. So I come to my WP config file. I will right click this and I will edit this. And then we will come down here. We'll see our database name. We'll see the user. We'll see the password and we'll see the host. So right now I want to update these changes. So this is my database here. So I'll copy the database name. And then I'll come back here. So I'll change the name and then I'll come back here as well. I'll copy the user, update the user too as well. And finally, I will update my password. So our password has been updated and the next thing we want to do is to hit the save changes button here. And that's it. This has been changed and we can come back now to our PHP my admin. What we want to do here very quickly is for us to update our website URL. To do that, we'll come to our tables here and we'll search for WP option. Okay, so we have that here. So we're going to open this up. And then we can see that our website URL is pointing to cbmastery.com. So we'll change it to dapsbrook.com. So to do that, from what we see here, it's obvious that our database was not correctly uploaded. So what I would do right now is to just click this and then we have to try this one more time. Let's just drop all our tables so you can see. Yes, I want to drop this. So this has been dropped. So if we click this right now, we have this table empty. So let's try to import this again. Okay, so this time around we have our import successful, and that's it. So we can now come down here, so we have our WP option here correctly, that we can then now update our website URL. So we can edit this, and then we can change this to dapsbrook.com. I will add the HTTPS protocol, and then I can just copy this, and then I can hit the go button. And then I can come down here too as well. I can edit this. Then I can hit the go button. I can change my blog name here. This is the title of my website. I can change my admin email. I can make some changes here inside our database. So that's what we want to do here. So let's go check our website. Let's see if this would work. So if we come to Dapsbrook right now, so this is no more Daps to Dapsbrook. This is not Dapsbrook directly. So I will just take Daps away and then I will load it. That's it. We can see that we have our backup restored here. And that's exactly how to go the long way, the manual way of downloading your database and then your files and then uploading them. But the not too good thing about this is that we still have to update our website URL. So if I point to buy now here, you can see the link down at the bottom of this browser. You can see that it's still pointing to mycbmastery.com. So I would have to go to the back end and update all the URL. So that's it for this tutorial. If this video has been useful, give me a thumbs up. If you have any issues, let me know in the comment section. I'll look out for them. And that's my time. I'll see you in another tutorial. Until then, have a nice time.